You know Algonquin Park. We had a cottage on that lake, and we would go there whenever we could when we lived in Toronto. And what we heard is the sound of the loon, that wonderful, lonely, wonderful, touchingly beautiful ta-dee-dum, ta-dee-dum, da-da-da-dee. I went to the Arctic, and of course I wanted to come back with something worthwhile for my use. After all, it is Canadian, even though it's another country, it's the Arctic. If you fly toward the Arctic, you look out of the plane, and the last row of trees is like a fence, and you know you're in the Arctic then. I'll never forget that. Well, anyway, I had them sing for me, and I taped them, and I came back with some music that the oldest Eskimo in the Arctic was this woman. And when I went to see her, she was lying in bed and talking to me. She had one picture on her wall, and it was President Kennedy. Oh, I just fell in love with her. Kalala, her name was. And so I got that. Then I got some material from a man who came to where we were, and he sang something for me. So I made use of this material, and I think I sort of got caught up in it. And you just can't be the chooser. You can't say, I'm going to do this and that, and you know, it's going to be in this style. So you really have no choice. You get started on something, and it just starts pouring out, you know. And I couldn't tell you how did I come to write it that way? Why didn't you do it that? Well, there's no answer to that.
Adaskin developed a style that was modern while maintaining traditional classical elements. And something of the perky French manner of Mio had rubbed off on him. But his voice was still uniquely his own. In 1952, his life took a hard turn towards teaching and administration when he was named head of music at the University of Saskatchewan in Saskatoon. Despite the new commitment, the compositions continued to flow through the 50s and 60s. Adaskin made use of folk elements in works like the Algonquin Symphony, Kalala and Nalaula of the North, and Saskatchewan Legend. He composed concertos and a series of divertimenti for soloists with orchestra, and many works for smaller ensembles and for voice and choir.